Hi, this is Rob. If you have one or more drones that you use as a hobby or recreation, you may have to register that drone with the FAA, Federal Aviation Administration. I'm going to explain the basic rules of drone registration. If you purchased or received as a gift a drone before December 21st, 2015, you must register that drone before February 19th, 2016. If you received your drone after December 21st, 2015, you must register that drone before your first outdoor flight. Drones weighing between 0.55 pounds and 55 pounds must be registered. That is flying weight. Weight after you add a camera or other accessories. 0.55 pounds is 8.8 ounces. If the flying weight of your drone is less than 8.8 ounces, then it does not have to be registered. If your drone weighs more than 55 pounds after all equipment is loaded or attached to the drone, then you cannot register it using the web-based system. If you do not register your drone, then you could face civil penalties up to $27,500. The criminal penalties include fines up to $250,000 and/or prison for up to 3 years. There are two ways to register, a paper-based system or a web-based system. The web-based system is much quicker and easier. To use the web-based system, you need to be at least 13 years old and a U.S. citizen or permanent resident. If you are under 13 years old, then the drone must be registered by someone at least 13 years old or older. If you are not a U.S. citizen or permanent resident, you can still go through the registration process, but you will receive a certificate of ownership and not a certificate of registration. Thus, you cannot operate a drone outdoors with a certificate of ownership. Before you begin the web-based registration, make sure you have your name, home address, mailing address if different from your home address, your email address. The email address will be used as your logon ID when you set up your account. You will also need a credit card for registration. The credit card is the only way to pay the $5 registration fee, and the credit card transaction also helps authenticate the person registering the drone. However, if you register before January 20th, 2016, then your $5 fee will be immediately credited back to your credit card. The FAA is doing this to encourage as many people to register before January 20th, 2016. The registration is valid for 3 years and must be renewed every 3 years. The registration fee could increase in future years. So, even if you currently do not have a drone, but are thinking about buying one in the near future, I recommend that you register before January 20th, 2016 to receive a free registration. Because registering as a drone hobbyist does not require you to enter a model number or brand of the drone or drones that you have. To register via the web-based system, go to www.faa.gov/UAS/registration. I will leave a link below in the description. Scroll down and find this blue Register Now button. Click on it to begin your drone registration. Your email address will be used as your logon ID when you set up your account. Registration with a web-based system will generate a certificate of aircraft registration that will be sent to your email address and also available for download on the FAA website. On that registration will include your name as the registration holder, the certificate issue date, an expiration date. The expiration date is 3 years, and also on that certificate of aircraft registration will be a unique identification number. That unique identification number is very important. You must mark all your drones with that same identification number. Yes, you can have more than one drone, and if you use your drones only as a hobby or recreation, then you only have to register once every 3 years and use the same registration number for all of your drones. You may use any method to affix that number to your drones, such as paint, permanent marker, label, engraving, or other means. As long as the number is readily accessible and maintained in a condition that is readable and legible upon close visual inspection. Your registration number must be visible. If your drone has an easily accessible battery compartment, you may affix the number in that compartment if that compartment doesn't require a tool to open it. The registration number on your drones cannot have any ornamentation, thus do not put any fancy design around the number. The registration number on the drone must contrast in color with the background. Thus, if you have a white drone, use a black permanent marker. In the near future, your home address will be part of the public record, so if somebody finds your lost drone and enters your certificate number in the FAA website, your name and home address will appear. When operating your drone outdoors, you need your certificate of aircraft registration in your possession. You must be able to present a certificate in either print or electronic format if asked for proof of registration. If you loan your drone to someone to use, anyone who operates your drone must have the registration certificate in their possession, either a print copy or electronic copy. If later you decide to sell your drone, remove the registration number from the drone before the transfer of ownership and log in to the FAA registration website and update your registration. Okay, that's it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel.